influence them again. Just spill my okay, so this video is about bitmap halftone in Illustrator. So everybody knows, I would hope, that it used to be stress, now it is breath. You can do bitmap halftoning in Photoshop. You know, you open your image, you go to grayscale bitmap, 300 as long as it's the DPI you need. Select your screen, halftone, blah, blah, blah. Okay. So here's what I want to show. If you have your image at the size it needs to be, okay, you can bring it directly into Illustrator, and these are two that makes me cringe actually, but let me bring these two into photos or Illustrator. Okay, let me bring these two over. Okay.
Uh-oh. Here comes trouble.
Ugh. Project I'm doing. Anyway, I'm not a political person, but I can't stand either one of these people. Anyway, so these were done in Photoshop and edited. They are of nice size, 12.5 by 12.5, but they're brought in at 72 DPI. Okay, saved in Photoshop at 72. If you were to save those at 300, then you would get that much more detail. But here's what I'm going to show you really quick. If you go to object, rasterize. Now here, if you were to save this at a Photoshop at like 1200 DPI, you could go other and save it at, well, 72 or 150 and get larger dots. It's saved at 72, and as screen printers, this may make you cringe. Let me back up really quick, and I'm going to duplicate this. Okay, this one I'm going to do at 72, and this one I will do at 300. And there's not really going to be any difference. It's not anything worth worrying about. So when you do object, rasterize, 72, you want to do transparent, otherwise it'll fill this background right here with white. Okay, then we'll select this one, remove object, rasterize, let's do 300. Takes a little while. The dot pattern is a little different, so maybe there is a small difference. Honestly, I don't. There's more detail in the 300, and that's just the way it is. But you could get away with, and also it depends on what you're trying to do. You can get away with the 72. So it really depends on what you're bringing in at. So let's do this. This person, I will refrain from comments, but do bitmap. Oh, sorry, I don't know if I touched on that, but normally the color mode you would do, be it like CMYK or grayscale or something, do bitmap. Okay, and there's the secret to this whole thing, but you do bitmap, screen 72, transparent. Okay, so now we can take her over here, and you know, as you guessed it, her favorite color is blue. So if we're doing a mock-up, we can change her to blue, or pink, or red, or blue, or whatever. It doesn't matter. You know, when you save a TIFF file and bring it into Illustrator, you convert it to a bitmap and save it as a TIFF file, you can do this. But this is just a really quick way, you know. There you go. There's your team. Blue jump. Oh, that's backwards, isn't it? Sorry about that. You got red Trump and a blue Hillary. Anyway, so that is the quick bitmap halftone in Illustrator. works really good, prints fine. Not fancy though. Like, and I say fancy because you can do, this is something else I was playing with, in Illustrator, I'm sorry, in Photoshop. Oh, it looks like I didn't save it. Sorry, well, in Photoshop you can do different angles and use line or dot or, you know. But, okay, so let's back up, and this is the Bitmap Halftone in Illustrator. So these will print at halftones. So if you were to, you know, you have this red and blue, if you were to save this as a separation host-based PDF file, you would get your two separate screens. Let's just pretend this is what you want. Or you can just change them back to black and print them. So I hope that was kind of informative, helpful, you know, who knows. Hopefully neither one of them, sorry, gotta refrain. All right, let me know what you think.